Let's go mudlarking!
It's official. Fractionally short of 14 kilos.
Try and have a bit of a dig around.
A light excavation. How exciting.
What a mess, Mr. Johnson.
I know, but here we are in the garden. Well, what a gorgeous day. Heatwave, that's what the headlines are saying in Wales. I may have mentioned this once or twice recently, but we've had a week of weather that is so glorious. And they've told us today could be the day when the thunderstorms arrive and the heatwave disappears. So we're going to make the most of it. Got my hat on to keep the sun off. Got the old short sleeves and no coat. And of course, today we're going to get some use from these polarized sunglasses that Derek bought us last year.
You try them on.
There we
this
go.
This is what they like.
Hello. Right, so what are we hoping to find today? Good question. I'm hoping to find little things. I'm always looking for brick and scrap, and I love anything we find here at the dump. But ultimately, it's the smaller things, perhaps if we look closely, with the sun shining, it might pick out those little gems. So what are you hoping to find, Caroline?
Well, if you look down, there are lots of rocks we could find things in. I'm hoping to find some fabrics, because I found some down here before, vintage fabrics. I can't see any from this distance. And I think I may find a cod bottle.
Oh.
I have some insider information.
I was going to say, that sounds extremely hopeful with our track record.
Yes.
But the water levels are low, the sun is high. We are out very early. We got up at 6:30 this morning because we want to get this mudlark done before the noon sun, because that's going to be a little bit too hot for all of us. Even Mankey, and he's used to the sunlight. So we'd better crack on and get this done.
Right, let's get started. It's a bit shady here, so I think I'll take my sunglasses off, put them on my hat, and we'll have a little look. Don't forget, shout if you see something. There are lots of little bits of china, but to start the day, I'm going to look for bigger things, because I don't want to carry too much back. And if I start carrying all the little bits of china back, we'll have tons. There's an interesting bit of china. Let's just have a look on the other side. Oh, it's got writing on it. Oh, look at that. Oh, I'm glad I turned that over. Okay, then we're going to look at things like that more closely. So let's have a look. Take me a second to put that in my bag. And let's have a look at this. Oh, look. I can't believe this, huh? I saw that bit of swirly and I thought, should I pick that up or not? But it's got a letter on it, so it goes with the other piece. Ooh. Any more here? Let's have a look. Do you think that's it? I think that's a bit fat. No, that's not off it. Oh, I wish we could find more. How is this? Something. No, I don't think that's off it either. What about under this stone? No. Oh, I really want to find the rest of it. Oh, is that a piece of pretty tile?
Oh, that's pretty. It's one of those Victorian tiles. There's another piece of tile. No, I think that's more modern. I'm not so keen on that bit, but I really like that one. Let's have a look. Is there any more of that? Ooh. And I wanted to find some textiles for my journaling. I'd like to do a junk journal, and I'd also like to do a sewing themed one. That is lovely. It's a bit of lace. I think we'll lose the stick. I don't want to take that home with me. Oh, that's very nice. Whoa, look at the size of that tooth. I put my hand there. That's a whopper. As you know, if you follow our videos regularly, I don't like teeth, so I'm not going to pick that up. Let's see what's in this little pile here, because I can see something with writing on. Super Comet. Ah, right. That could be the rest of it. We'll just take the Super Comet bit, I think. I like that. I think it may be part of a toilet. Oh, there's a piece of jawbone there with a small tooth in. Yes, I'd say that's probably off something like a toilet. Any other bits here? What's this? Yep. More and more I'm thinking, that's a loo. For the more eagle-eyed of you, you may have noticed I'm wearing different wellies. Margie bought me a spare pair of wellies. So now I have two, in case the one gets full of water. And look at that. Put my foot there. They're leopard skin all the way down. Ooh. Very posh. But they've never been in the water. Well, that's just not acceptable. So I think we need to go for a paddle. So come on. Pop your wellies on. We're going in. Oh, this water feels lovely and cool on my feet today. It's so hot. The strange thing about this bit of river is there's not a lot in the water. It's mainly on the banks. The birds are singing away today. They're obviously really enjoying this weather. But there's the river. And there are the trees. What's that? Did somebody spot something? Look at that! That's quite a substantial bit of tile, isn't it? Off a grate, I'd say, or fireplace. That's really nice. 20s, 30s, do you think? Oh, is that a fossil too? Let's pop that down. I think that could be a fossil. I'm not sure, but I think it could be. Let's put it there. Don't know if you can see it there. Let's have a look there. I'm not used to the distances for getting this camera to focus, so I hope you can see it. Hello, Mr. Johnson.
Hello. I have to say, I'm very impressed with your tile.
Oh, thank you.
I am. That's a very nice bit of tile.
I didn't spot it. It was one of the viewers shouted out. I heard them clearly.
Well, we'll have to see if we can find a few more, and then we can redo the bathroom.
Oh, yes.
Or maybe the very small toilet.
Hmm.
You know, if we had a tea bath, we could always do that out there with that, with some nice edging. Anyway, I found a couple of nice things.
Oh, right.
I found my typical scrappy things.
Right.
And I am in the process. I have hidden one I'm digging out at the moment, so we can share it together, because it's looking very interesting.
Good.
So, I'll put your tile down.
Right.
I'll start with the nice things.
Go on then. Oh, that's nice. I love these little flask shaped bottles. It's lovely.
We have found a couple of those down here.
Something written on it. Do you know what's written on it?
No. I didn't notice the writing. Oh, hang on. Wonder what that says. We'd have to get our glasses out after and have a look at that.
I'll tell you what, tune in to the live show Saturday night, 9 p.m. UK time, and we'll let you know what it says, because neither of us are wearing our glasses.
And I might even clean it up.
Oh yes, that would be nice.
And look at that one.
Oh, that is so cute.
It's a little cutie one. Looks almost like something It would have had
Harry Potter type potion bottle,
yeah,
isn't it?
A medicinal type of thing, or something from the chemist, I would say.
Iodine, do you think? It's very brown inside. Yeah. Hold it up to the light. You can see it's brownie in this. I think that's probably iodine.
Then we've got some scrappy finds.
Oh, let's have a look at your scrappy find. Let's
we've
have a
got
look.
This.
Oh, that's
it's a seal or a bearing or something,
right,
isn't it?
It looks to me like a bearing. I know I have no idea when it comes to technical things, but I have played a game where you had to find the hidden object and it had a bearing that looked like that. That's what I'm saying, bearing. Ooh,
let's
that's
say that's
nice.
Bakelite switch off a radio or TV.
Could be. Looks like, yes. Oh, I like that. Very nice.
To go with your medicine bottle.
Oh, a medicine spoon.
Rather plastic.
It's a cute little spoon, isn't it?
And then, I'm not sure what this is, but it's got those little inserts like you'd use to put a bell bin, but it's rather peculiar shape.
From a car, do you think? Car-like
car bell. Yeah, could be, because that would go with my car mirror.
I think we found the other one of these a while ago. Oh, we have a pair now.
Oh, there we are. We'll have that car built in no time.
Oh, yes, it's going to look a right vessel. So.
Handle?
Oh, I like that. That's a really heavy one. I don't know if the ring used to drop, probably, it's just it's sort of rusted into place. Oh, more Bakelite?
Yes, and I think a blast from the past. A few people have mentioned this company. I think it's a Red Effusion switch.
Oh, right.
I think that's what it says in there, but I haven't got my glasses on.
Yeah, I think it says Red Effusion.
And Red Effusion were massive in this area.
Oh, yeah.
Richard often mentions them because they run so many cables through here because we, living in the valleys, we had no TV signal. So Red Effusion would put big pylons on top of a mountain and then run cables from them, and they run cables to everyone's house, and we all had to switch our TV over on the switch on the windowsill.
Yep.
Those were the good old days, and now look at it. We're on the internet. Anyway, that's the scrap. That's the pretty finds. The reason I'm holding my little magic diggy that I found on a beach some time ago is because I did start digging.
Oh, right.
And I decided to stop.
Oh, look.
I decided to stop because I thought it was, I thought it was another one of these
type bottles.
But then I found this. Now, the reason I'm pleased is because it's solid.
Oh, that so is
so. Usually you get something like this and you catch hold of it and it comes out, but it didn't come out. It won't pull out. So I decided to try and have a bit of a dig around.
Excavation. How exciting.
Because what's happened here is this has all been ploughed down. And that's, these bottles have come from elsewhere. But this
is a long neck on there.
It's very
Look
peculiar.
The size on that.
Very peculiar.
It's not a sauce bottle, is it?
No. I think it's
Oh,
I tell you
wow.
what.
Oh, look, it's an Eiffel Tower.
It's smashed.
Oh,
but
look at that.
It's got 3 out of 4 feet.
Poor thing, let's have a look there. It's not in there, is it?
I got a feeling that's a nasty bang. I think the digger took that out.
Yes, it's a big chip off it. Oh, what a shame. But look at that. It's an Eiffel Tower pretending to be the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Is that impressive or what?
I'm impressed.
Look at that. Ooh. What have you got?
Right next to me, as I dug that out and then passed it to you and looked around, it's Bakelite, and that's definitely a light fitting.
I thought it was brass for a minute.
No, that's definitely a Bakelite light fitting.
Yep. Oh, that was good.
In fact,
interesting hole, that
probably had a button on it to push
it
through because you used to be able to switch it on and off on you.
There's a beautiful view of the river, but I've spotted something strange. Can you see it? If I go this way, something going on here. There's something hanging in the water from a tree. Look at that! It's a bottle. I wonder if it's an ancient bottle from the earliest times of bottle making. How did it get there? Did it get trapped? Let's see if we can get it. Oh, got it! Look what I found, Phil! It's a bottle!
I will try and look amazed. Wow, you found a bottle.
I did. And there's something special about this bottle. Let's take it out of the water. It's got a funny shape to it. It looks vaguely like a cod bottle. Do you think this is a very old cod bottle?
No, I think it's a very new cod bottle. Ooh. And I think you just discovered my personalised refrigerator.
It's lovely and cold when it's been in the river.
I know, because that is a cod bottle purchased quite recently and given to us as a gift by Audie, and I thought I'll bring it and put it in our supernatural fridge, because even on a hot heatwave Welsh day, the river runs cold.
Oh, do you want to open it? We'll have a drink.
Why not?
Ramune strawberry flavour.
Why not indeed?
Phil is just sitting on the stone getting ready to open our bottle, and I look down by my feet and look what I found.
Oh,
a little cute, full of sand glass bottle, and it's a really pretty amber shade. Oh, that's nice. It's a screw top, but it's a cute screw top. Lovely size. Look at that. Right, Mr. Johnson, I'll stop being distracted.
Right there. Two things to say before I open this bottle. Number one, as mudlarkers, we like to take rubbish away. We do not bring rubbish to the river. So just for everyone to know, I retrieved the rest of our string from the tree. We haven't left it there. And number two, I don't know if Caroline noticed or if you noticed when she was filming, but when I suspended this, I held it so that it was 3/4 in the water and 1/4 out. There's a good reason for that. Ultimately, this place is idyllic, but there's rats and all sorts live in this river, so you can't be sure the water is clean. So that way it kept the body of it cold, but the area that we're going to be using to drink from is free from germs. So I thought I'd mention those things because we wouldn't want to cause anybody any injury in the future.
Yes. Right, so how do you open this cold bottle?
I don't know.
First of all, you need to take the plastic wrapper off.
Yes, I can see that. That seems to say on you that you have to take the plastic wrapper off. I'm trying to figure out how you do that. Hang on, I'm going to need glasses. Definitely not sunglasses, I need my other glasses.
While Phil takes the wrapper off, we'll pop home, make a cup of tea, have a sandwich, come back, and he may have finally got his.
Are you being sarcastic?
No, of course not.
Right then, it says to peel the wrapper off. See, it says by there, peel wrapper off. There yeah. We are, quite clearly, but then it doesn't say whereby. Here we go. I'm going to go
bathe. Oh, look at that. You're a genius.
Now
oh,
there.
Look, you can see the marble at the top. I did open one of these on a live show, but I didn't really have the time to thoroughly enjoy looking at the construction of it. Look at that.
So, a bit more rubbish to go in the bag. There we go. There's the marble.
It is. Ooh.
In the top of the bottle. And this is our little plunger.
Ooh, it's a plunger.
I presume. To pop the marble, is that right?
Put that on there. Now, try it. How's that going to work?
And then press that middle bit.
Right.
And then put it down.
I can't remember now. It was a couple of weeks ago we opened the last one. It sounds like you've broken your plunger. Oh! There he goes.
There we go. My thumb is now down through the plunger.
Ooh! Is the thumb in the plunger?
And the plunger comes out. The marble has dropped down in there. Can you see the marble?
There
it is. One fizzy marble.
One marble wobbling about in the bottom of a bottle, and our bottle of Ramune strawberry flavoured carbonated soft drink. Let's try it. Oh, it's very fizzy.
Very fizzy. The principle of using the carbon bubbles to keep the marble in place is still working over a century later, and still keeping your drink nice and fizzy. Right. Cheers, Oddy, and thank you.
What do you think of that?
Oh.
Lovely and cold, isn't it?
I get the feeling there's a bit of sugar in this.
I think there may be. It's rather sweet, which suits me perfectly.
Now, while we enjoy this cold and refreshing drink from a cod bottle, which is the nearest we've got to finding a whole cod bottle, even if it is only about 3 months old.
Yep.
We're going to let you have the chance to catch up on our garden, because we've had so many requests for an update. I'm sorry we can't give the coverage we gave last year. Last year we were in total lockdown, only allowed to leave the house to walk around the block once a day. So we spent all our time in the garden for 6 weeks and filmed it. We reclaimed our garden. You can look at the videos if you haven't seen them. But we just like to give you a little bit of an insight into the damage done during the winter, the repairs that are being carried out, the projects that are in place, and of course, the beauty of nature. So you go enjoy that while I enjoy this, and when we'll get back to the mudlarking.
What a mess, Mr. Johnson.
I know, but here we are in the garden, and isn't it looking fine?
Nope.
And smelling rather strong as well.
Yes.
That's the imitation creosote that I've been using. You can't use creosote anymore because it's got carcinogenics in it, but they've got something that smells as bad and hopefully works as well, because this is Action Stations. It's all happening here. The shed, after over 25 years of traveling and being moved from house to house and place to place, suffered a rather bad winter and is in a rough way. So I decided if I had to replace, I was going to expand. And expand I am, because I'm stood in the middle of a new area that's being created here, which is 6 foot 6 by 13 foot, because this is going to house my new workshop, come shed, come studio, and come place to put everything that's under Caroline's feet at the moment. People keep asking, where are all the finds? Well, they're going to be in the shed when it gets here, and that's due in a couple of weeks. But meanwhile, we've had to put new fence panels in over on that side of the garden because they got blown down in a storm. This all got trashed, the hole there. Well, I had to take it from, renew all the timbers from there right the way down to the corner, then right the way across. The two main posts holding the gate literally fell to the ground and took the gate and the fence with them. So this has all been renewed. As you can see, the old gate is now abandoned there. And look at this, how posh are we? Look at that.
Ooh, paving slabs to go out the back.
They wanted over £100 for a gate in Wickes and B&Q. £7 in the auction. Can't be bad.
My greenhouse has a lovely view. Look at that. It's all Phil's wood where he's working, and rubbishy wood that has to go to the tip. But here are my tomatoes. I nearly said potatoes. Tomatoes. They're just starting to get some flowers on. And there's a little marigold. I always put a marigold in because they help with the white fly problem. This is a Chinese lemon cucumber, I think it's called. So that's growing away nicely. And oh dear, that one isn't looking very well, is it? I don't think it got enough water, but the rest are fine. And that'll perk up. It's amazing how much abuse the tomato plants can take. Up here are my hanging basket. Tumbling Tom, I think these are called. And they've already got some little tomato flowers on. And over here are some more. These are just donor plants that are just going to get thrown away, really. I've got nowhere for them. Poor things. It's pointless putting them in the garden in Wales because they will just get blight. If I move those out of the way, here we have a pot of leeks that are ready to go in now, so I'll put those in the garden and we'll have some nice leeks growing ready for the winter stews. I've got some aubergines here and here. This is a globe artichoke, but it didn't do very well. The ones in the garden are already about a foot high. This one is tiny. And we've got another Chinese cucumber, some more eggplants, some basil waiting to go into a pot. And I think that's about it on things to show you. There's another little bit of basil.
So We are midway through, I hope. Well, it feels like it anyway. I've been working in the evenings because it's so hot here, but we're getting there. This should be ready to receive the shed. That should be going up by the beginning of July, and hopefully then we'll be able to film from the shed. It'll be fill the shed as well as fill the mudlarker. So lots of things come in, lots of updates to happen, but we wanted to share with you today. Hope you've enjoyed seeing the projects that are happening here, seeing the mess that we're in, seeing the shed that if I opened that door would suddenly lean 18 inches that way.
Show everybody what's behind you. Come on, no good standing what? In front
what?
Of that.
What's behind me?
This is the state of the shed. It's completely rotten. This here is one of the main supports that's holding it up, and it's completely rotted away.
I'm sure I can do something with it. But it did need replacing.
It did, didn't it?
Well, it wasn't big enough for our new ventures, shall we say. So there we go. See you back here for updates soon. But now, back down to the dump and the river, and let's see what else we can do as we go mudlarking.
Aha! Here we have evidence that there have been other bottle diggers here, and they've left this because this is just put on the top. So I don't think that just arrived on the top like that. It's got... I thought it was the top of a flagon, but it's not, is it? That must be in there. Don't know if we can clear it. There must be a waste going through there that comes out there on... Oh no, it's the top of a toilet. And the water comes down there, out of the little hole there, and then flushes the bowl.
And the bolts for the seat go there.
Aha! So now we know it's a bit of a loo. There's a lot of toilet here today. Is there a pattern on this? Ah, there is, but I think that's more of the loo that's just there. And... Oh, I thought that was a whole bottle. Just as a matter of interest, the word loo, it began when the people would throw their excrements and things out of the window. And so they'd shout, look out below! And one of the ways you said that in French was garde l'eau. Be careful of the water coming down. And that changed to garde l'eau, loo. And that's where the word toilet came from. And there's a toilet or a loo. Ooh, is that a bit of pipe stem? Oh, look, it is. It's almost the bit that goes to the bowl. You can see the beginnings of the bowl there. Oh, how lovely. And it's got something written on it. Not quite sure what that is because I don't have my glasses. Oh, and look, there's some lino. I love my vintage lino. Wow. Oh, I'm really pleased with those two finds. Not everybody's taste, I know. Vintage lino, but I love it.
I found a brick.
Oh, and Phil's found a brick.
I found a brick.
It's a brick. What's on your brick?
It's a Risker brick.
SJ and Co. Limited Risker.
There we go.
Do you have one of those?
I think I do.
Right.
But just in case.
Can't have too many bricks.
You can't have too many bricks for Risker.
You can.
Well, possibly, but the car's not too far away today.
No.
Is that a bit of tile down there?
Yeah. Oh, yes, it is. Oh, it's just plain. It is tile, but I'm saving myself for exciting, pretty things today, so I'll leave that for somebody else. I was just filming Phil there, who's now collecting up his bits and pieces, and I looked down and guess what I saw. I think it's pipe stem, but it may not be. And I'm pretty sure it is. Yes, it's a pipe stem. Look at that. Now, if we hadn't chosen that particular place to film, we never would have found this, and the river would have washed it away next time there was high water. Oh, lovely. I do love a good pipe stem. Oh, look! I think that's probably a Heinz tomato sauce bottle. Full of mud, screw top. Very nice shape.
Could be mayonnaise.
It could be, or salad cream.
Ooh, yes, salad cream.
There's a pretty piece of china. It's blue and white, but I don't think it's willow pattern. Nope, it isn't. It's a pretty floral one. Is there anything else from that particular plate? Well, there's a neck of a bottle. No stopper in it though. And have a look. What's that? Oh, look! It's got some flags on it. That's nice. Oh, I like that. Yep, we'll take that home. And I can't see any more of that blue, but I may have just missed it. You see it? Ooh, there's a pair of wellies. Ooh, there's a pair of legs. It's a fill.
Hello.
Hello. I put the camera down to see if you can spot what I spotted. Something glinted in the sun. What glints in the sun? There's a dog going crazy up over on the field. Can you see it? It's a coin. I don't think it's an old coin, but we'll have a look. No, it's a UK coin. Quite modern. Oh well, it's 10p. And on the way to find the coin, I passed something down here. Let's see if we can find it. It's something we find regularly on a mudlark. That's the only thing, you take your eyes off something for 1 second and it gets eaten. Ah, there it is. Can you see it? I can see it. It's some ridged pottery. What is a mudlark without ridged pottery? I have seen as well. Thinking about my collars is this old bit of sacking. That would be nice. I'll give it a wash. Maybe that will go in a journal. Maybe it can go in a collage if I can't get the bits off. I'm definitely taking that to do some art with. I can see a bottle. It's a brown bottle. Or an amber glass bottle. Just there. I don't know if that's old or not. Got a screw top. Got some writing on the bottom. It doesn't look very old. It's very shiny. It isn't very well worn. Let's see if I can show you. What do you think? Is that old or not? Phil is over in the distance. He's gone down to look in the ditch. And I'm going to go and work my way back to him. And the temptation to look down is there. But on the other hand, it's really important when you're mudlarking not to forget to look up. Look how green and lush everything is. It's early summer. All the plants are enthusiastic. They know they've got several months of sunshine coming. And they are performing perfectly for us on camera. I love glass blowing. It sounded like I said glass blowing. I meant grass blowing. Look at that. Very majestic. Fortunately, it's a breeze rather than a gale, which is much more expected in Wales. We do have thunderstorms coming. But look at that. You've got the still waters there, which almost is undetectable that there's any movement in it. If it wasn't for the bubbles along the top, and then it all narrows down over there, and then you can see the white water and it gets much more fast flowing. We've got over in the growth here, unfortunately, we've got knotweed, Japanese knotweed. We've got, look at that beautiful foxglove. Let's have a look at it. Quite often you'll find a bee up inside the flower, but not in this one today. You can see all these little buds, they keep going and going and opening up and opening up. That one will probably end up about 5 foot high by the time it's finished flowering. Going in here, don't panic, we don't have many snakes in Wales, so I haven't got to worry. We've got a thistle. Very pretty, I wouldn't want to cuddle it, but it's very pretty. We've got dandelions, which are always with us, especially in the lawn. Not quite sure what these pink ones are called, but I'm sure somebody on here will know. And there,
We've got a dandelion clock. Now, apparently, you can tell the time by seeing how long it takes to blow the little fluffy bits off the clock. Let's have a look. One, two, three, and we're getting nowhere. Maybe it knows it's later in the day or in the morning. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, there are a few more on there. Another two blows, three blows, and I'm running out of breath. So there we go, according to that, it's 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon. I wonder if that came from when, as the day got drier and went on, it would take less time to blow the fluffy bits off, the seeds. And so in the morning, it would take you many more blows and you'd get sort of 10, 11 blows. But in the afternoon, after the heat of the sun, one blow and they'd all be gone. And it would be 1 o'clock. Interesting. I wonder. Right then, let's make... Oh, we've got some clover down here. White clover. We do get some pink clover. Not quite sure what they are. We do get wild strawberries too. I haven't seen any of those at the moment. They have self-seeded into our garden. Now, I don't know what this is, but my friend used to call it chickweed and feed it to her budgie. So maybe it's chickweed, maybe not. Look at that pretty foxglove. Poisonous, but so pretty. And so useful, because we can make digoxin medicine out of these, which saves a lot of people's lives. But don't eat the flower. Unless it's been properly processed and unless it's been prescribed by a doctor, it's going to kill you. Ah, I can see Phil in the distance. There he is, we got to go up and run. Can we go this way? Let's have a look. Oh, they're big leaves. If I put my welly there, quite a size. And there's Phil. Right, we're coming, we're coming.
I wanted to point out, We are slowly losing this dump.
Yes.
Because as you can see here, the tracks of the big machine moving the earth out, which in a way is sad.
Yep.
But it brings with it its positives.
Right, and what positive have you found?
I will show you now.
Oh, right, we'll follow you.
There you go. I have been down here and I've been excavating with me little diggy.
Oh, yes. A very professional excavation tool.
And I've left one or two that I still want to excavate, but some were lying on the top, but I found some interesting things.
Right. Ooh, let's have a look.
There's an interesting piece of china.
Oh, right, let's have a look why that's so interesting. Oh, wow.
Another cracker.
Look at that pattern on that. Let's turn you.
If you can have a bit of blue and white.
There we go.
So there we go. I got that.
Very nice.
And then.
Oh, Shippum's space box.
I got a. Yes, it's Shippum's.
Shippum's. I'm collecting these for a project, but I need so many of them.
Well, I got good news here. Because see by your feet.
Where?
There's one I spotted which I haven't got out. Look.
Oh, yes, I can see the bottom.
I don't know if he's old and I don't know if he's Shippum's, but there we go.
It doesn't matter if he's not Shippum's as long as he's a space box.
He's Shippum's.
Oh, good.
He's a twin to that one.
There we go. Another bun.
A bit more pumpkin.
I probably need about, at least 100.
Oh, right. I found one of them, and I don't know what one of them is.
All right. I've seen these before. I think there's some sort of small insulators off an electric fence, but that's just possibly.
Look at that.
Oh, a little sweet jar again. Oh, it's got a little bit of a chip on the rim. Not too bad, though.
And it may not be a pipe stem, and I know you found a significant pipe stem, but I think it will get a bit of a cheer from those who like us to find... What are they?
Oh, a bottle stopper. Oh, it's such a pretty colour too.
Isn't it?
Let's see if we can show you against the sunshine or whether it'll just disappear.
It's got a bit of age. It's got a bit of a chip, but it's got a bit of age. And then we've got a bit of a brown theme.
Right. Amber, darling. Amber. Sounds better.
Okie dokie.
We've got a little mini beer bottle. That's cute. And cute little bottle, that's nice. It's definitely more amber than brown, isn't it? Look at that.
Now, I know the contents of this are not original.
No, I don't think anybody bought jars of dust.
But again, I gotta mention it does remind me of the jars my granny had with malt in, and she used to give us a spoonful of malt every night.
It could be some that child sort of look thing. Forward to their malt out of this jar every evening. Lovely. Look at the sun through that. It's just stunning, isn't it?
I thought that was quite a nice, all things that have been disturbed by the digger. But some things have been broken, because you will see an awful lot of smashed stuff around. So I have two smashed things.
Right.
Which I'm not necessarily going to take home with me, but that's...
Oh, I love that.
I just can't help it. You know, folks, I love survivors. I think something that has been through the mill and come out and maybe misshapen, but it just makes it unique. Because you may find a million bottles made by that company, but you'll never find one that shape.
No, and it does look very drunken, doesn't it?
And I offer that as encouragement to everyone out there who's been through a tough time. There's not another one like you. You're unique, and it's the things we go through make us who we are. So there we go. I like that. And this one you like.
Right.
You like this broken bottle.
Right, okay. Bottle.
You will like that broken bottle.
If I swap you for that broken bottle.
Yes, you can.
Oh, it's got a stopper in.
That's why you like it. I thought you would.
Can you see what the stopper said? It's got a W on it.
It's got a W, and I did put my glasses on to have a look. And it said London on the bottom.
Right.
But I can't make out the company.
Whitbread, possibly?
Possibly. But it's definitely London. And while the neck is not worth preserving, I think the stopper is worth taking
off. Look at
that.
There you go. Put that there. Right.
So.
Oh, I like that.
Even broken things can be beautiful. There we go. And produce treasure.
Here is all the broken china Phil is talking about. And the reason why I'm down in the hole is because... Oh, just a second. Is there something written on that? I will be back. Oh no, I thought it was something written. It's not, it's just a bit of an insulator with some black on it. Anyway, as I was saying, the reason we've come down into the hole... Oh, Phil's found something else.
What's that under there? I hadn't spotted that one before
jar.
You arrived.
It's not a Shipham's one, but
might be nice. That's a cute size just to put a little bit of water in when you're painting, isn't it?
I really like that.
Baby food, do you think?
Could well be, yes.
I seem to have flashbacks of 40 years ago, having jars like that around the house.
Could be.
And they, as I said, see, shame about how they break as well. The machinery, that would have been a whole bottle, but the machine has took it out.
Oh well.
May have took this one out. I left it in situ because I came looking for you. So here we have the bottom of a bottle, which looks positive. There's a little
chip there. Oh, it's wobbling a lot. Always makes me nervous when they wobble, I think, are they whole. Oh, it's more of it than I expected. Oh.
Aha.
Oh, look!
It's actually a small bottle.
Now, is that... I think that's nail varnish. You can see the pink in there.
At first I thought an ink bottle, but then, nail varnish.
I say nail varnish.
1950s, 60s, 70s, anything like that.
I don't know this.
We're going by all the other things here, 50s.
Yes, it could be then.
50s, I'd say, because they made the bottles, I think... They started going with the slender bottles after that. So possibly that's a chunky bottle. I did mistake it then when it came out. I thought, ink, and then you're right.
I thought for a second.
It's either pink ink.
It could be.
Or nail varnish, and I think nail varnish wins the day. Well, I've got the camera for a moment, and I'm just taking a look on this high bank. Now, it's interesting with this bank. We look on it each time we come here, and we tend to see different things. Because obviously it gets disturbed, the rain comes, and at the moment the sun has been shining, it's drying this soil and it's just blowing away and exposing things like the cup handle there, which probably wasn't in view before. A few bits of broken stuff. There's a car light bulb, is it there? Just in there, set into the ground. Just here, there's a bottle. A bottle that's been exposed, and pick it up. Oh, I wondered if it would have had writing on it, because some of these do. This one doesn't, but it's quite a neat little size. Quite a cute thing. What do we have here? Oh, I thought there was a pattern on there, but I think it's just the scuffs and marks. There we go. It's a bit exciting, but still. It is a bottle. It is a little bottle, and that fits very much with my plan for today. So I think that one is going in the bag. There's the old spoil, the slag from the mines there. Plenty of that around the place. But, so you see where it just sort of dries out and comes away. Always a chance of a pipe stem or a glass bottle stopper or something just running out with the dirt. What's that there? Up. Now I spotted this, which is a tiny little bit of glass vial or something, but when I climbed up, I noticed this. Aha! Now that does have something written on it. Carters? This is a Carter's quality product. I think that one is worth popping in the bag as well. And I didn't see that until I climbed up for this little bit. This little snap top vial. There we go. It's funny how you find things that you're not looking for. Whoa. There we go. Well, we haven't found any ridge pottery today, as far as I'm aware.
Yes, we have.
Oh, there we are then. Well done, dear. You have made this a mudlark with ridge pottery and a ball and your pipe stems.
Well, I'm a natural.
You are a natural. There's no denying it. And it's unusual to have you on camera showing your finds and me standing on top of a hill looking down.
Hello, Mr. Johnson.
Hello.
What have you got?
I've been busy.
Right.
I've been searching, I've been finding, I've been washing and cleaning. Now, ooh, they're not quite shiny, but they're a lot better than they were coming out of the ground. But before I show you anything else, I came down here to the riverside to wash my finds. And some of you may remember a brick, very heavy brick.
Yeah.
Metalline, I believe it was.
Right.
And we found it some months ago here on this dump. And I put it down and I forgot it. And when I come back, they bulldozed everything and it'd gone. And I just found it.
Oh, well done.
I just found it right on the water's edge. As you can see, it was sat in the water.
Oh.
And there it be.
There you go. Trademark Metalline.
So, that's coming home with me.
I'm not surprised.
Hee-hee. I refound a brick. Now, for my finds, which are on display here on the riverbank.
Oh, look at this. Very a la posh. So let's have a look at your finds.
Now, I don't know if this one's got any age, but it has
plastic?
Got a nice colour.
Oh yes!
And it's got a lovely emboss on the other side, which makes me think it could be a more modern drink. I don't know, we'll have to check it out.
It's a really nice colour though.
I thought it said deposit on the bottom, but it seems to say depose.
Yeah, depose then, I suppose.
Depose. It's going to be French, I take it. As soon as you said it with a French accent.
Déposé.
Déposé, madame.
Monsieur.
Ha la la. So there we go. If anyone out there recognise that, that is a bird, a stylized bird, on top of what looks like a stylized shield with possibly some kind of insignia or something in it. It's a coat of arms of some kind, isn't it?
It is.
I can actually see it quite clearly from the back as well. Ooh, where should I go next? There's something you like.
There we go. I love these. These are really useful for my art. Milk glass little paste pots.
And that's not nail varnish.
No, that is an ink jar or inkwell.
There we are.
Lovely.
There we go.
Here goes.
And then what else have we got? We've got this cute little one.
Oh yes, that's nice. A little bit fatter on the bottom. Not quite sure what that one's off.
And then we've got tablet bottle.
Oh yeah, or pills.
And then before I show you my last bottle, I'll show you my two little pieces of china, see what you think of those.
So are we going to play plain or patterned?
Well, there's just two pieces. Do you fancy your chances?
Let's play plain or patterned. I think they're both patterned. Let's have a look. No, we go for plain on this one. Oops. No. Ah, that one's still alive. That one's patterned, and well, this one's going to be patterned as well, but we'll say this one's plain just for a laugh. And it's patterned, so there we go. Whoa, two to fail.
Yeah, but it doesn't feel like a victory. When you say, I think they're both patterned, so I'll say plain, that's really edging your bets, because what a hollow victory for me.
Yes, I saw it.
Not to worry, we'll call it a draw. Thank you.
two things here. There's an old toothbrush, or toothbrush. Ooh, not really pleasant. Really interesting shape on the end though. And look what's next door to it. It's a whistle. I wonder if that's an Acme whistle. They usually were. Oh, it's even still got the pea inside. Oh, that's really nice. I like that. There's a little bit of rust on it, but it's not in that bad condition. Oh, that's a nice little dish. Look at that. That's off a doll's tea set, I'd say. I can't see anything on the bottom. But what a pretty pattern. I'm sure we can do something with that. Oh, that's coming home with us. There is a lot of modern rubbish down here. We do take as much as we can, but there's only a certain amount you can carry. It's a lovely little bottle. Oh, that is nice. Very sweet. I love a little bottle you can fit in your hand like that. This looks so cute. Oh, there's a piece of blue and white. Can you guess what pattern it's going to be? It's willow pattern. Oh, that's in a really bad way. There's a little bottle here. I think this has been dropped by a bottle digger, so I'm assuming it's nothing terribly exciting. It's a screw top. It's not too bad. But I would imagine if you're a bottle digger hoping for bottles with hundreds of pounds, then it's not the one for you. Oh, that, I think it's somebody's old bucket and spade. Well, bucket that went with the spade. And it's in really poor condition. As I'm touching it, it's breaking. I wonder if I can get that home. Well, if it doesn't survive, I'll put it in the bin. I like that. There's a bottle stood up there. Oh, it's been there a while, hasn't it? There's gooey bits in. There's an amber glass bottle, and there's a broken bottle. And there's a not broken bottle. There's nothing written on it. Screw top, probably sauce, I would say. That's a shoe. I'd say that's a 70s shoe. No make on it. Anything inside? No, that's long gone. Can you hear the cockerel? Over here. That's really pretty. Look at that. It's a little orange flower. Oh, so sweet. And let's have a last little look here. Oh, look. Some interesting things. There's a broken teapot lid, but I've seen some really good things up there. Right. Got to see if we can get them now because this is very unstable. By and then the thing written on it. That was plain white. And this is another plug. Oh, it's got a pulley thing. That's a nice one. Ceramic plug, I like that. Is it a fuse holder? Yes, I would say, at a rough guess, because as you know, I'm not very good at this, that's for holding fuses. And then you poke them into your fuse box.
Now for my last bottle, not my last find, but my last bottle, because having said I was looking for small,
well, that's definitely small.
I have to be honest, the colour and just the size, everything about that typifies what I set out to find today.
Where's the sun gone? Up there. Very pretty. Like a greeny aqua colour. It's more pale green than aqua, I think.
It's nice though.
It is very pretty.
Then I have a second bottle stopper.
Oh, well done.
Or should I say half a bottle stopper.
So you've got one and a half.
I've got one and a half. And it doesn't quite match yours, I know. But
for this dump, stem.
Two pieces of pipe stem in one day is pretty good because we don't find them often here. And my final find of the day.
Oh, another one, yeah.
Yeah. Something I wasn't expecting or looking for.
Fossil?
But after such a flurry of fossils in various places, I found a fossil here, I think.
Oh, yes, look. It's
vegetation.
I think so.
Probably, yes, I would say so. Carboniferous period.
Yeah.
But very
it's a fossil,
nice,
isn't
yes,
it?
It's a genuine fossil.
See
that.
The shape and the ridge in there.
So very thought, clear.
There we are, just for our rock hounds out there who may be feeling a little bit sort of all forlorn with all this stuff off the dump after all the visits we've done to various places. There's more fossils coming, folks, don't worry, but we found a fossil today. What was your favourite find? Mine was the little bottle. What was yours, Caroline?
Mine was a little piece of vintage lace that I found. I'm going to wash and put
I often say about how heavy my bag is, so I've decided to weigh the bag now and see just how heavy it really is. Well, there you have it, folks. It's official, fractionally short of 14 kilos. Don't know if you can read that there on the scale, but I knew it was heavy.